Even if they cut my body, even if they cut my body, into 2,000 pieces.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First and foremost, we would like to extend our gratitude to the organizers of this event. Inshallah, even though we can never do the justice of the masaib of Yahya al-Bayt, we pray that within our midst, Sayyidina Fatima Zahra, who's present, accepts our azar, accepts our lamentation, and accepts our tears, inshallah. Over the course of the next 20 minutes or so, we've been requested by some of the brothers to do the masaib and to remember the day of Ashura. And inshallah, we'll focus our recitations on two personalities on the day of Ashura. One was Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, and the second one is Sayyidah Zainab salamullahi alayha, and we have a lot of salawat.
Before we begin, could we just ask for the lights to be dimmed, please? Because I want you all to close your eyes and cast your minds back to that day. And I want you to really take your minds there. On the day of Ashura, 61 AH, very soon before the time of Asr, you find Sayyidah Zainab sallallahu alayhi is sitting inside her tent, and suddenly she sees a shadow at the door of the tent. So she walks up to the door of the tent and she moves the curtain aside, and there she sees her beloved brother Hussein covered from head to toe in blood. For a moment, he stares into the eyes of Sayyidah Zainab, and Sayyidah Zainab stares back into his eyes. This is that very Zainab who has seen her beloved sons Aun and Muhammad be killed. The very Zainab who has seen her beloved Qasim's body being trampled. The very Zainab who has seen her Ali al-Akbar with a spear in his chest. The very Zainab who has already bid farewell to Al-Fadl al-Abbas and has never seen him again. This same Zainab looks into the eyes of her brother and she knows why he is there. But listen to the way in which Imam al-Hussein says goodbye to Sayyidah Zainab. He says, "Oh Zainab, within my belongings there's an old torn shirt. Can you go and fetch that for me?" So Sayyidah Zainab goes back and brings that shirt and then she kisses the neck of Hussein. Imam Hussein says to Sayyidah Zainab, "Why did you kiss my neck in such a way?" And she says, "Oh Hussein, our mother told me that when Hussein comes to ask for this shirt, kiss him on the neck for me because you will never see him again. And the next time you'll see him, he'll be having his neck slain." This is what Sayyidah Zainab says to Imam Hussein.
As you stand alone, you're looking left and right. Can I just ask you, as you leave to fight, my footsteps by your strides. I'm gonna scream aloud as your pure neck is hacked away. I'm gonna see you in my dreams, see you every day. I'm gonna think of you on that road every step of the way. I'm gonna see you in my dreams, see you every day.
Your tears tell about your broken heart, your bowing head reveals your every scar.
That when Sayyida Zainab set off from Karbala towards Kufa, she turned around towards the battlefield to look back at the battlefield. Why? Because during the time she departed from Imam Hussein, she used these verses.
If there's no one to prepare you for the war, you know Zainab would give her life. Without any words, a meal done on the floor, and with these hands, I'll help you climb your horse. I'm gonna help you now, I'm gonna help you now. Who will help me after today? I'm gonna see you in my dreams, see you every day.
These are the final words Sayyida Zainab says to her brother.
As you walk away, it breaks my heart to see every few steps you turn to look.
Say,
I will stay strong.
make you proud as I'm dragged away from where you lay. I'm gonna see you in my dreams, see you every day.
It is said that when Sayyida Zainab returned back to Karbala on the day of her reign, she came up to the graves of her brother in such an ajeeb way, in such an unconventional way. It is said that when Sayyida Zainab comes up to the grave of Imam al-Hussein, she doesn't just walk up to the grave of Imam al-Hussein, she comes on her hands and knees, crawling. No one knows the real reason why she comes, but it is as if she's coming begging for forgiveness. Why? This next verse will tell you.
You have left me with a gift I must return, a little princess,
for years who you had yearned.
It is said that our bodies are confined to three dimensions, but our soul is infinite. It can transverse, it can transect time and space. I want you to take your soul back to Karbala on that day. It's 61 AH, it's the day of Ashura. You can feel the heat of Karbala, the burning sun upon your heads. You can feel the breeze of Karbala upon your cheeks, between your toes. You can feel the sands of Karbala. And your master Hussein leaves the tents towards the battlefield. It is said that in 3 days of thirst, this Hussein fought a battle that was like no other. This is the Hussein that had lifted and carried back body after body after body. His face was covered with the blood of Ali al-Asad. And this Hussein comes to the battlefield where he faces 30,000 of the enemies. It is said that Imam al-Hussein battle was so intense that he slain and he killed 1,950 of the enemies. The time of Asr approaches. In Ziyarat al-Nahiyah, Imam Zaman alayhi salam depicts the scene so clearly. He says, as the time of Asr approached, the Arabs were fighting in such a way that it is as if there was an eclipse in the sky. It is said that those archers who fired the arrows aimed straight for the chest of Abdullah al-Hussein. It is said those who had spears in their hands then ran forward and embedded their spears into the chest of Hussein. Those who had nothing to throw at Hussein picked up the sand of Karbala and threw it into his face. It is said that my master starts swaying on his horse, and as he falls onto the ground of Karbala, his body is suspended upon a bed of arrows. Those of you who know the geography of Karbala know that the place where Imam Hussein fell from the horse and the place where he was martyred is a long distance away. The reason for this is that when Imam Hussein falls onto the ground, Shimmer steps forward. And as Shimmer steps forward, he grabs Imam Hussein by the beard and he pulls him towards it. He then drags Imam al-Hussein across the plains of Karbala by his beard up to that place where he had his final martyrdom.
It is said that then the enemy starts encircling Imam Hussein alayhi salam as if a predator is encircling his prey. And this is where Sayyidah Zainab comes in. Ziyaduddin Ali, Imam Zamana, says that Imam Hussein was laying upon the ground of Karbala out of the corner of his eye. Zainab caught his attention. It is said that Zainab was standing with Dilla Zainabia, and Imam Hussein was watching her. And Zainab was watching him. Imam Hussein started shedding tears, and Zainab was shedding tears. It is said when he saw Zainab, this is the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, but lying on his own right. Imam Hussein starts getting up, putting power through his hands, and as he gets up, he just about manages to get onto his knees. Someone steps forward and kicks him back to the ground. He just about steps forward onto his knees again, someone hits him over the head with a spear. It is said then Shiva steps forward. Zainab is watching. A few steps away.
Zainab stands there and looks on at Hussein.
Around this place.
Imam Hussein lay there with no helper on the grounds over the plains of Karbala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the angels.
They said all the angels came down and went straight back up, and they said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can't bear to see this. The prophets one by one came down and they all returned back.
It is said that the seal of the prophets, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, came down and he had to go back up. Imam Ali, Imam Hassan alayhi salam,
none of them could see this sight.
But it is said in his final moments, Imam Hussein rested on the laps of the
and in narration it said even a shiver was going to take the dagger to the neck of Imam Hussein. He could hear a voice in his ear saying, what is my Hussein ever done to you? He's thirsty for 3 days. What has he ever done to you?
Why, I ask you, my sisters who are mothers will know this. A mother will give up everything she has,
sacrifice everything she has, take spears into her heart, just to give her child one moment of comfort.
A voice is heard around these plains as a lady embraces the head of Hussein. She cries aloud, puts her neck on his head. I'm his mother cut my neck instead. It's the final strike and Hussein's last breath. He thanks Allah as he meets his death. Lady Zahra cries with a broken heart as the head and the body come apart. As the head and the body
on the day of Ashura, Imam al-Hussein placed the soles of his blessed feet on the burning sands of Karbala. He looked up towards the heavens and uttered those immortal words, those everlasting words, and he said, help me now, Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone to help me? On that day he knew that he faced an army of 30,000. He wasn't talking to the army of 30,000. He was talking to the generation. He was talking to me. He was talking to me. He was talking to all of us. And he was asking us, when your day comes, will you stand up for the truth like I stood up for the truth? And will you stand up against injustice like I stood up against injustice? And here, sitting in Manchester today, we make a pledge to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Our children, our men, our women, our elders make this pledge to Imam Hussein. And we meet your voice when you say, help me, Ya Rasulullah. And our voice meets your voice and we say, Labbaik Ya Hussein, to your call. So I want you to all raise your hands, both of your hands, and make this pledge to Imam Hussein that from today forward, whether it's in your own houses, in your neighborhoods, in your schools, in your workplaces, anywhere in the world you see injustice, you will make your voice heard. And when you raise your hand and say, Labbaik Ya Hussein, you're making this promise. Every together, 10 times, Labbaik Ya Hussein! 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 Labbaik Ya Hussein!